Hey guys, what's up? It's Andy. This video is going to be about prospecting, lead generation, and referrals. All right guys, so look, we're gonna talk about lead generation. Lead generation is something that most salespeople don't know how to do. And look, repetition's the mother of skill, okay? In the beginning, what I'm gonna teach you right now to be a top sales associate is how to generate your own leads. So we're gonna start out number one with lead generation. Now let's talk about some things that don't cost any money, it's just sweat equity, which means you gotta show up and do the work. I'm gonna start out with number one. We're gonna talk about Facebook. Facebook is probably one of the most powerful things out there that you can leverage and use for lead generation. Why? Because everybody's on Facebook. So there's some things that I know. So most people between 7 a.m. and 10 a.m. in the morning, when they're at work, they're what we call scrolling. They're scrolling through Facebook. You know what they're doing? They're not working. So if you were to post on, like, let's say Facebook Marketplace, at that time, you're gonna have a lot of browsers, okay? Now I'm not talking about car salesmen not working, although that hopefully isn't you. I'm talking about sales associates that are working to post their cars on the market to catch our customers scrolling by vehicles that we have to create interest. Maybe they have an itch. They want to look for a certain vehicle. Maybe it's not today, maybe it's in the future, and you're going to scratch that itch. How are you going to do it? You're going to do it by posting an ad. So I would recommend, number one, we want to start out between 7 and 10 a.m. in the morning, post one car on Facebook Marketplace. The marketplace is a place that has hot and cold in-market buyers right now, okay? Cold means this, maybe they're 4 to 6 weeks out. But if you post a car today, there's a good chance that they could reach out to you and be in the market today, all right? Scratch the itch. Then you have hot, which means in the next day or two, they're looking for a car to buy. So they're on there looking for, and by the way, you can post cars all day, every day, but I wanna tell you how to start your day. So prospecting, I believe, can be done midday, but needs to be done in the morning. Get in on the early shift. Go outside. Look, let me give you some examples. You say, Andy, what do I post? Well, post something that's hot, okay? Something that's unique, okay? When I say the word unique, let me explain what I mean. You're taking a 2011 model and it's got 40,000 miles. Well, it's an older car with lower miles, that's great. You're taking a 2019, but it's got 90,000 miles. Well, that means somebody can get in a 19 model and it's gonna be priced less than the market usually has it priced because of the miles, okay? And that right there could generate a lot of leads. But also you could have somebody that could find an attractive car like a 2011 with really low miles that even though it's pre-owned, it's new to them and their family. Maybe it could be a lifted truck. Maybe it's a diesel. Something that you see out of your inventory that you're like, you know what? There's a butt for every seat, right? I got that. But there's a specific car today that I bet if I had posted, somebody would definitely be interested in it. Use your gut feeling for knowing your business and find that car and then go and post it. So what I'd recommend is that you could use the dealership pictures, okay? But I like to take the vehicle. I like to go photo it myself. Take 4 to 6 pictures, pretty simple. Take that vehicle, go post it in a nice little, or go take pictures in a nice little area, and then come back, go to your laptop or go to your computer or go to your cell phone and go to Facebook Marketplace. Not on your Facebook page, but Facebook Marketplace. Go through and post it. Now your ad copy is really important, okay? I want you to think about how cruise line ads work. They show a picture of somebody taking a cruise. There's beautiful people, there's sunshine, there's palm trees, there's water. You know, people are laughing, they're having a good time, they're relaxed. You know, make it look like it's a once in a lifetime find. So let's talk about Facebook on your main page, right? Facebook post. You obviously have people that are in your area. Let's say you live in San Antonio. Well, if you have 1,200 friends, you have access to 5,000 friends on your Facebook page. Go and start messaging or sending friend requests to everybody in your area if you're in San Antonio and get some more friends. So what you can do is that also when you put that car on Facebook Marketplace, you could also take and put that car on your Facebook post every day. Now, that means the people that are your friends will see that post, it'll pull up in their feed, so when they're scrolling, they'll see what you have for sale. Also, you have what's called Facebook Story. So you have a little story box, okay? And it looks like this, and it allows you to add a 26-second video. As a sales associate, I would say you take 26 seconds to talk about the special that you have. This isn't really your pictures, but it's a video of you in front of your car. So you'd say, hey guys, it's Andy here. Look, I'm sitting here. I got a 2011 model Ford Fusion. It's got 40,000 miles. Guys, it just came in last night. I can't believe we just traded for this car. Look guys, if I had 100 of these, I could sell 100 a day. Nobody knows that we have this car. If you're looking for a new vehicle, guys, I've got this. Once I put it on the internet, it's gonna be gone. This is an early bird special. Reach out to me, 999-999-9999. Guess what? I have this car. It hasn't even hit the website yet. Let me tell you about it. Boom. Post that 26-second video on your, look, let me make sure you understand, on your story, okay? That's your story. You got your Facebook, which is called your post, and then you got your Facebook, which is called your marketplace, which means this is actually where cars go for sale and people look for cars that are for sale. So that is gonna be a form of lead generation that I would tell you. Now, secondly, you could also post on Craigslist. Craigslist is hot. It does cost $5 per post to post on there. This one's free, but if you have a really unique, hot deal, rare find or something, put it on Craigslist, it's great. Okay guys, so listen, let's talk about as a sales associate, what it means to know how to prospect. Now look, as a sales associate, if you're on the showroom floor, your service department is always humming, always humming. You can always walk over to service and meet somebody. That's what prospecting means. Okay, lead generation and lead gen means to actually go create an ad, maybe make some ad copy, take pictures, and try to create someone to reach into you. These customers, most of the time, are already in your store. So you could always go over into the service drive, and obviously, I don't care where you're at, as a sales pro, as a sales associate, your dealership needs more inventory. It's just the truth. There's a shortage of inventory around the world right now. So more cars equals more sales. So you could always walk over into service and say, hey, how you doing? My name's Andy. Great to meet you, number one. I just want to say hi. I'm glad you're here today. What are you in service waiting on? And they can tell you and then say, hey, I just wanted to say this. Our dealership is giving more money right now than what cars are worth. It's crazy. We're selling cars faster than ever, but they love pre-owned inventory. Would you mind if I ask you a question? If I could give you more money than what your car was worth, more money than what it was worth, would you entertain selling it to us? And they say, well, what's it worth? And you say, hey, great question. Look, let me get to that. Secondly, if you did get more than what it was worth, what would you replace it with if you did sell it to us? Would it be something less miles, bigger, smaller, maybe newer, brand new again? What would it be if that number was right? That right there is called prospecting. Guys, I wanna tell you, to work your service drive and to work your service station, you have to understand, it's one of the hottest areas in a dealership. The trades are the best, the customer's already there in the dealership, they haven't done a lot of research, but who doesn't wanna upgrade for a great deal? So as a sales associate, learn how to prospect. It is very important, and you'll never lack it in your service department. Okay guys, so let's talk about number three, which is gonna be referrals. Referrals are everything. Guys, listen, men and women, sales associates, all the top professionals in the world in the automotive industry, understand you spend 2 to 3 hours to deliver a vehicle to sell it. Why wouldn't you want that customer to send their friends and their family and to come back and buy all the vehicles they're gonna buy for the rest of their life and make that first 2 or 3 hours you spend with them count for the rest of their life? You've got to look farther than the hand in front of your face. You've got to be able to look out here and say, look, the best opportunity that any man or woman could ever ask for is in the automotive industry, and it comes from referrals. So scaling your income as a sales associate will happen by creating a pipeline of referrals as you continue to sell. So 1 year, 2 year, 3 years, 4 years, on your fourth year, you shouldn't even ever have to go out and do lead generation or prospecting because you have so many referrals coming in that it's just your day set before your day's even here, okay? These people that you've sold one time, they want to purchase something again and it's their time back around. So number one, how do we handle a referral, okay? And how do we start it? So if you don't have any referral business right now, number one, first day call after they buy, obviously, tell them thank you. 3-day call, 7-day call. Thank you. Thank you. Any questions about your car, any of the way it operates that you don't know about or understand? I just wanted to make sure. Maybe I'm reaching out too much, but I'd rather reach out too much than maybe you not reach out to me and tell me that there's something wrong or there's a problem. I just want to be there for you and serve you at the highest level and give you world-class customer service. When you do that, it's just finding bias to your customers that you were as great as you were, that you were a genuine person. You didn't just do a thank you, there's your car, and then if you need something else, let me know. You really stayed in tune with them and told them that you were different. If you act like your competition, they'll treat you like your competition. Don't. This is a chance for you to really prove that you're different after the sale, which will really truly create them as a referral and make them loyal to you. So my goal is that you do that first week of follow-up, and then after that, you know, you have your monthly follow-up every month. You need to call them and say, how are you doing? I just wanted to reach out and say hello and say thank you. If you're not gonna make time to pick up the phone, you're not making time to scale your business. Now, whenever I talk about referrals, something that's really important, you can get referrals from the person you just sold, but also the person you just sold could send you a referral, okay? One of my favorite ways to do it is to leverage social media. And what that looks like is this. I'm a sales associate. I have Miss Johnson. She just bought a brand new BMW. I would say, Miss Johnson, I would love to inspire other BMW buyers out there that are like you, that this is a great place for them to come do business with. Would you be okay with that? I'd love to make a 5 to 10 second video. I'd love for you to be in it. I'll do most of the talking if you'd be okay with that. They say, sure, that'd be no problem. I say, hey guys, what's going on? It's Andy, I'm here with Mrs. Johnson. Guys, look at her brand new BMW. She just purchased it today. She's amazing, she deserves it. But Miss Johnson, what did you think about the service you got today? Was it great? What do you think she's gonna say? She's gonna say, oh my gosh, it was amazing. You guys are awesome. Say, Miss Johnson, I can't thank you enough. Congratulations on your brand new vehicle. Look, if you ever need anything, I got your back for life. I appreciate you so much. That's it. And then what you do is that you'll post that on your page, but you'll ask, you'll say, would you mind if I friend requested you right now and you accepted it, and then I tagged you in the post? I would love for you to share the celebration on your Facebook page. Would that be okay? What do you think they're gonna say? They're gonna say, sure, that'd be all right. So now they've done add to profile, they've put that on their page. Now Mrs. Johnson has your video you made with her in it and her saying to her 5,000 Facebook friends that she got a great experience from you. Now I want you to watch this. This is very, very important. You can't miss this part. People are gonna start commenting on her page or liking it on her page with her purchase. When they like that, I call it turning leads into likes, which is actually another form of lead generation and prospecting. And what you do is that when that person likes that video, you want to take that like and click on it and see who it was, because you'll get notified. And then you want to basically send a video and say, let's say her name was Ruby, she liked it. I say, hey Ruby, what's going on? It's Andy. Look, I sold Miss Johnson her car. I saw you thumbs up that we were celebrating she got it. Number one, I just wanted to reach out so you have a name with the face. I was the one that sold it to her. She's amazing. Look, if you ever need anything from me, my cell phone number is 999-999-9999. Reach out to me. Let me know if there's anything I can ever do for you. Have a blessed day. Boom! Now, all of her friends got a video from the salesman that sold her the car saying, you're awesome. Thank you for thumbs upping and celebrating with her. If there's anything I could ever do for you, let me know. Here's the deal. You may have one person reach out and say, I've actually do got a question. Do you have any of these? Bam, lead generation, referrals. Somebody comments below, never fish in the comments. Remember I said this. Somebody comments below and they say, oh my gosh, Judy, beautiful car. You need to comment and say, thank you so much for commenting on Judy's video. She's amazing, she deserves it. And now that person, right? You don't say, hey, reach out to me, I sold it to her, shoot me a text message. You never fish in the comments. You DM them behind the scenes, and that is where you're gonna get your best referrals. Now listen, if you did this with every car you sold, and you sold, I don't know, 200 cars a year, I mean, you could only imagine how many people would learn to know who you are. Look, who are you? What do you do? Are you great at what you do? And where are you? If people don't know who you are and what you do and where you're at, I mean, what does it matter? Your goal is it more important for you to know people or for people to know you? It's more important for people to know you. And you sell cars and you give world-class customer service, They need to know who you are and what you do. Guys, if you will follow this, you will have more referrals than you know what to do. But always remember this, consistency is key. You can't do things once in a while. What's practiced in private is seen in public. These are things that aren't fancy. You do them behind the scenes, but all the top sales associates, the one percenters, they get more referrals and they know what to do with it. They never have to wait on a customer for the rest of their life. Instead of chasing customers, their customers chase them. Okay, guys, you made it to the end of the video. You are the one percenters. Do me a favor, shoot me a text message, 918-210-0254. Listen, let me ask you a question. Are you making $250,000 a year selling cars? Are you making $500,000 a year selling cars? Why are you accepting less than what you're worth? Don't be afraid. Don't be paralyzed with fear and indecision. Reach out to me, guys. I made $700,000 a year selling cars. I will help put together a strategy and a game plan for you, specifically for you, how you can dominate it in the store that you're at. Shoot me a text, 918-210-0254. I got your back for life. Let's crush it.